What goes into your creation process? Like, when you guys are making this music, like, what goes on and how do you do it? I know that's a ridiculous question,
We got it. It'll start with, usually with some sort of inspiration, and that could be any number of things. It could be something musical, like, you know, maybe a keyboard part that one of us played, or some drums that one of us made, or it could be a cool sound that we recorded walking through the park the other day. It could even just be, you know, we're feeling the moment, and something's inspiring us. So it starts with some sort of inspiration like that. And the way we kind of collaborate and put it all together is we'll sit here and listen to it for hours. And a lot of times it'll come out great. A lot of times it won't come out so great. I'd say a lot of the stuff that we make never sees the light of day, but we just like having fun with it.
Yeah, I'd say maybe even 15%. Of the actual process turns into something resembling a finished product.
Yeah.
But yeah, like he said, inspiration comes from all over. I could read something. He could look at something. Sometimes inspiration sails are filled simply with the winds of our own farts. It could come from all over.
As far as like gear that we use, you know, we use the computers and Ableton Live. There's a few hardware synthesizers behind you. We use software synthesizers. Lately, we've been getting into like a lot of lo-fi techniques, like you know, cassette tape, you know, recording on iPhones, recording on the microphone right out of the computer. Combinations of those, you know. Record a sample you got on your iPhone into the cassette tape, run it in through the microphone on the computer, you know, take a room recording. It took us a while, but we found out that we're not good at making music sound good, so we're kind of going with this thing now where we make it sound like shit. And we're pretty happy with the way it's coming out.
Very, yeah. Start with as good as we can get it, and then make it worse from there.
Yeah.
What kind of artists are you guys, tuned into right now?
A decent bit of shit. There's a label out of Seattle that, recently turned on to called Hush Hush. A lot of really, really good artists on there. Definitely listen to a bunch of that.
Yeah, Symbols Recording. That's another record label I've been digging on a lot lately. You know, it's always changing what we're listening to. Flying Lotus has a new album coming out. Of course, we're psyched about that. Our boy Float, we recorded at his place. He's always got shit that I love. Gotta throw a shout out. Check out Float.
Still, though, among that, as much new shit that comes out, I feel like I spend a lot of my time listening to the same fucking albums that I've been listening to for years and years, over and over, three times a day.
And what's that?
All the good Boards of Canada shit, and, you know, Old Burial and Bonobo and things like that. I have never been able to steer too far away from your day-to-day experience.
Yeah, there's a lot of good music right here in Philly, too.
Actually what I was going to ask next.
Yeah.
As far as, like, local acts, then maybe not everybody in Brooklyn or wherever have found. Mm-hmm. Like, who would you say locally would be somebody that someone should check out?
I think Brooklyn would like Damn Right a lot, although they might be picking up some steam there already. The drummer, Tommy Breda, lives up there. Let's see. Local artists I've been digging lately.
Oh, you know, he's walking around somewhere in California or possibly Oregon at this point. He may have made it that far, but the good homie Dan Castle. Phenomenal cellist. We've had the good pleasure to work a bunch with him pretty recently. but he does a lot of really cool solo cello looping. That's a treat to be able to observe and see his process and mastery around that task. It's pretty awesome.
Grimace Fed. They're one of my Grimace Federation, one of my favorite bands in Philly. They also have another project. It's two of those guys, drummer from a band called Brothers Past. That's The Beating. That's very cool stuff. That's another cool thing about Philly, too. All the musicians kind of collaborate together. So we've got to play with a lot of these guys, too. You know, we're producers, you know. We don't really play instruments too much anymore. And we still get to, you know, make music with these guys. We got to play with Corey Riker, who's done a lot with the Roots crew. That was a lot of fun.
So, Beam&Deem started when?
What was it, sunny summer morning? Or sunny April morning?
I think it was in April 2007.
Yeah.
Yeah, about April 2007, we
loosely.
Started out.
Yeah.
Loosely. And then we started performing, actually taking it out and releasing music, what, 2009? Mm-hmm. 2008, 2009? Mm-hmm. Somewhere around there.
Yeah. How many releases have you guys come out with? Like EPs and albums?
I guess EPs, there are three of them.
Let's see. The first one we released was Circuitous Route to Nowhere in Particular, which is terrible.
Yeah,
and after that...
There was one dude in Florida that always bumped the one track from it, but...
Right, yeah, some people liked it, that's for sure. We definitely got some props on it, but we listened to it again recently, and it's terrible. then we had those two mixes, right? Was that the next thing we came out with?
No, the Dirty Apple Party was somewhere in there. Yeah, Dirty Apple Party mix was probably... 2009-ish.
2009, maybe, yeah. So that was like 30 minutes of, you know, all original material in a mixed format, which we like that format.
Yeah,
we've done a few of those, actually.
Mm-hmm.
So then, yeah, I think the next release was...
A couple more of those in fall 2010.
Yeah, so we did two of those, Circle Square and Both for Colors. Those still hold up.
Sound better backwards.
then we put out an album called Eat Sided, and then our latest release was in January. It's called Just Another Day. That's when we really started getting into those lo-fi techniques I was talking about. It was, you know, putting the music together over like the fall and the winter, and just locked up here and making really weird noises, and kind of just came into this album. Then we put out a mix in the spring that featured some songs from the album and some unreleased materials, a couple of choice cuts, then a few tracks here and there. So, you know, we don't put out the most music of, we're not as prolific as a lot of the guys out there, but we like to think we put some care into anything we put out.
And, what's next on the horizon for you guys? I know you're moving away, Zach.
Yeah, I'll be a bit far away, but you know, we've done it that way in the past. That hasn't really stopped us.
Yeah, the pretty beautiful thing about this medium is that it's pretty easy to, you know, craft something here, kick it over there, and likewise back and forth, reciprocating and continuing to develop ideas. And it's the actual distance itself isn't much of a hindrance in the creative process at that point.
Yeah, so, I mean, no plans for any specific releases as of this point, but it'll be coming soon, so keep an eye out.
So our whole next release is going to be built entirely.
Just that.
Thank you. That's not it. See? Indeed. To the house. To the house. Sorry.